Now every time I get the blues, I walk the soles right off my shoes. I don't know why I love her so, that gal of mine lives down the road.
Hi, Jim here. It's April 6th, 2013. I'm at Sand Ridge State Forest, just north of Forest City, Illinois, about 6 miles north of U.S. Route 136. This Sand Ridge is a state forest that has some ancient sand dunes in it. A big portion of it is an oak forest, and the northern portion is a pine forest. Right now I'm standing in the pine campground. I'm going to get to the trailhead, and I'm going to do about 6 to 8 miles on this beautiful 75 degree windy day. There is some cloud cover. There is about 30-40% chance of rain, but we will be able to have a camp and possibly have a fire, depending upon how high the wind is tonight. Okay, I'll get to the trailhead and start walking. Okay, well, I just got on the trail, and I'm gonna do the, I believe it's the Orange Trail. This park, at one time, was a desert. That's right, it was a desert. And there's cactus right along this trail here. The trail is completely made of sand. It's a big, wide equestrian trail. And I can't believe it, it's cactus right here in Illinois. It's astounding. Anyway, sun's trying to break through, and I'm just gonna follow this main trail here and start hiking. I didn't really get on the trail until about 1 o'clock because I drove around to find the proper trailhead. The trailhead I'm starting at is really the equestrian trailer parking lot, and then you go north from there. Okay, this is Jim, signing off for now. I want to make sure I get a good shot of this. I mean, that is just deep sand. Deep, deep sand. Okay. All right. Whew. Taking a break here. I'm on the Yellow Trail, and I'm way at the far west portion. It's blue and yellow. And I'm between campsites Backcountry 9 and Backcountry 11, and I just climbed up about 150 foot hill through 6-inch deep sand. Woo! I'm telling you, man, hiking in sand, this is killer. Try and walk on the edge of the trail as much as possible where there's some roots and some grass, but most of the time you can't, you know, there's the brush is too thick. And you got to walk in this thick sand. Holy moly. Well, I left the parking lot and went all the way down to Sandwich Road. I walked west on Sandwich Road for an eighth of a mile. And then I've been coming back up north on the yellow and red trails. And then the blue and yellow trails split off and head basically north. I passed Backcountry Site 9 and coming up to Backcountry Site 11. And that will, when I get there, then I'll be headed back east. And I've got to go all the way, at least a mile across the park to get to Backcountry Site 12, which is my site for tonight. I'll have to cross Pine Valley Drive, go past a parking area, and then get to the campsite. It's about 3 o'clock now. I've been hiking for you know, 2 hours. So, it's my leg's gonna hurt tomorrow. That I know. Slogging through this soft sand. Okay, this is Jim. Gonna have a little power bar, and then keep going. So here we are. It's 4 o'clock. Here's my campsite. Campsite 12. When I got here, I had a wool t-shirt on underneath my shirt and long pants. It was cold when I left Chicago, but it's hot. It is a beautiful, beautiful spring day. Beautiful. Okay, let's, I felt some rain. Let's go set up camp. Okay, well, I got the hammock set up. And I have nothing up there that's really gonna hit me. These pine trees are swaying in the breeze, baby. Swaying in the breeze. But it's a nice campsite. Got a fire pit, some logs to sit on, and a backrest. Can use that as a backrest. Need the log up against it. Okay. It's about 4:25. And yeah, took me a little longer to set up because I took the tarp and had to squinch it down a little bit, and then I had to take everything out of my backpack. And okay, hammy's all set up, underquilt's on, top quilt's in. Gonna batten down the ends of the tarp, and then get set up for dinner. Okay, looking forward to having some dinner. The sun broke through, but the clouds have come back. I don't know if you can see. The sun is trying to break through. I don't know if we're going to get anything, any really significant rain or not. They say we're going to get some rain, but I don't know. Okay, I'm going to cook dinner here. I got the Elkey burner, and we're going to get that up and ready. I've got 2 cups of water in the Bamusa 10 centimeter. And I get my windscreen out here. Okay, I think we need to go ahead and get it fired up. Oh, come on. Guess I gotta turn this up, huh? Okay. Oh yeah, that's burning. Okay. I believe it's burning. Yeah, that's burning. Yep. I thought it was. Yeah, something's burning. Okay. Oh, there it goes. Now it's blooming. Okay. There we go. All right, now let's see if the side burner works properly here. The flames might be too high. I don't know. Put my lid on. Uh-oh. Did it go out? Yes, it did go out. Okay. Guess I didn't let it bloom quite enough. Okay, there we go. Put a little heat on there. See if I can get this thing to bloom. I can see the alcohol starting to boil a little bit on the inside. Maybe I just need to put the windscreen up. Okay. Alrighty. Okay. Put the lid on so we can get a good boil. Okay. All right, we've got the koozie here with the lid. Got our cup. I have to water. There's my fuel, and the food is in the food bag. Tonight we're going to have, let's see, Mountain House, and we are going to have. What are we going to have tonight? Chicken teriyaki with rice. Okay. I got a punky log burning there. Yeah, nice fire. Okay. Well, good morning. It's about 8:30. I got up about 7, tore down camp, and hit the trail. I'm now southbound on the Green Trail. It's a crisp, cool morning. It rained heavily last night. I was high and dry in the hammy, the beautiful tarp. So I'm gonna head south a couple of miles. That'll take me back to the car. Beautiful, beautiful place here. Wow, just sand, lots of sand, very soft trail. Real nice campsite last night, had a nice fire, and feeling good. Fresh air, the dew has settled here. It's gonna take a while to burn off, but we're doing okay. All right, we're gonna, I'll give you a kind of a 360 here. Yeah, we're in the, definitely in the pine forest here. Now the trail says, or the map says that I take this trail only a short way to catch the Brown Trail, which should go south past the archery range and the trap range and take me back down to the meadow where I started the hike yesterday. So, but it's beautiful, beautiful forest here. You can see it's a reasonably mature pine forest. Okay. All right. Okay. Yep. All right. I'm gonna get going and might give another report before I get back to the car. I can see the end of the trail here. Coming down to the end of the Blue Trail. It's a beautiful morning, and the rain saturated the sand, so it's a little bit easier to walk on. But this is a really nice park. It's big. It's fairly remote. When you're talking about, you know, state parks in Illinois, I saw 4 other campers last night, total. And they probably camped a good mile away from me, at least a mile away from me. While I was hiking earlier, I tried to get some photos of it. I saw a pheasant, I believe it was a ringneck pheasant. That white ring around the neck, the black head and the brown back. But if I'm not mistaken, I'm going to come out right at my car. That's interesting. Looks like I can see my car. Okay. I thought I'd have to go a little bit west. All right. Well, this is Jim wrapping up an overnighter at Sand Ridge State Forest.
Now down the road, just a mile or two, lives a little girl named Pearly Blue. About so high and her hair is brown, the prettiest thing boys in this town.